Hello and salam everyone, my name is Mu'tasim and I am back with the next installment of Amira, a series about documenting the creation of my own game. If you haven't watched the previous video where I introduce this cute waifu Amira, my cute waifu Amira, then be sure to head over there and give it a shot and see the origin of the Amira project. I want to preface this video by thanking each and every one of you that have watched and commented on the video. It means a lot to me and it helps me keep pushing forward and making the project better and better. This week I want to talk about a very sensitive topic where I seriously hope and pray that I do not get a harsh backlash on it. I am not really sure how to get started with it. So basically, it's about women clothing and choosing the prettiest dress for my lovely princess. I really need to stop getting sidetracked and focus for a little. Okay, so here we go again. Women clothing, its symbolism and expressing it through not only the design of Amira, but also through the gameplay. The game is based on a Middle Eastern fantasy culture, and if you ever heard anything about the Middle East, you probably know that women clothing is one of the more prevalent topics that at least the media love to talk about a lot. And this will be today's topic, discussing my attempt at merging the complex cultural stance of clothing with the game through the gameplay. Somewhere deep inside of me, I like to believe that no matter how you look, then it won't matter. And what matters most is what's inside of you, your brain, your heart, your personality. But sadly, reality is so different. Depending on how you look, then people can have some truly bizarre reactions to you. Just changing what you're wearing from this to this, and even this, can have maddening influence on how people treat you. And if you haven't experienced it firsthand, then you most likely either have not thought about it too much, or you can't really expect or estimate how different and how bad the treatment can be based on your dressing or color or whatever other distinct feature that you have. Now that is something I would like to investigate more deeply, perhaps in my future games, but that would be because that would be far larger in scope than what Amira could do in a direct manner. In simple words, based on how you dress, you yourself change in some manners, and the world around you changes, meaning how others around you treat you. For this video, I'll focus on how you yourself change based on how you dress, at least how Amira herself changes based on her dress. Initially, my plan was for Amira to be dressed in the long dress in certain levels and in the short dress in other levels. But at the very start of the development, it was only a costume that had no effect on the gameplay. Though it had effect on the story, where it would change how the characters would interact with Amira and how the story flows, basically. In other words, it was only a simple representation. It was nice. I really wanted to make a main character who was dressed in what a lot of Middle Eastern women would wear. But it still felt not good enough. It was a good representation, it affected how the story flowed, and it changed the story in a format that might not happen in other cultures. That was great, but I still wanted more. It was a story being told, but as I said, I still wanted more. I want the players to feel some difference, something that would pull them more closely to Amira, something that would drive the message that changing what you're wearing can change a lot, even about the person themselves. And with my non-existing budget, the best I could think of was as follows. First, designing it on paper, thinking about the emotions that a Middle Eastern woman would go through when she makes a choice to wear some longer dresses or some shorter dresses. It might sound somewhat insignificant at first, but it really is not. So here is how it went. After finishing some proper designs on paper, thinking it would take me a week, maybe 2 weeks, it ended up taking 6 months with me reworking some systems and the requirement to create almost double amount of the content. So my first step was changing the base stats of Amira based on her dress, which meant I needed a stats system, a simple stats system, nothing over the top, but a new system that needed to be made. Now, a big disclaimer, even though I am not a woman, I did my best research and reading polls, articles, discussions, real life stories, fictional stories, and almost anything that you can think about. So, in simple words, it's just that I did my best. So, and another point I'd like to make is that what I'm going to say right now might not hold true for other people, might not hold true for other cultures. I mean, it might not even hold true 5 years from now. Nobody knows how the general mind of the public would change. And who knows, maybe I just did some not that good of a research that it doesn't even represent anything right now. But so that's why I am saying take it with a grain of salt. It's my result, my research, and what I did for the best of my ability. So here we go. In the Middle Eastern culture, many women would wear this style of clothing, long and covering and so on, for feelings such as like extra feelings of safety, peace, and modesty. And in theory, it should empower women by taking the focus away from the woman body and making the focus more on themselves, their personality, their self, and keep the focus on their brains, what they have to offer, the way they speak, their manners, and so on. On the opposite end, a Middle Eastern woman may choose not to wear it for feelings of being liberated, not tied down, confidence with yourself, strength of not letting external influences affect who you are or what you do. Now back to my stats system. This we could tie this information with my stats system. Now back to the stats system that I have coded, and combining this information that I have gathered with it, I decided to go with an approach where basically I take the most prominent and the most repeated feelings and emotions based on each dress and try to represent that through Amira, basically by giving her different stats. Let us start by the long dress. Now, peace and safety were the most prominent features that I have heard. I mean, the most prominent words that I have heard being repeated. And in my mind, these two can be linked directly to better health, being more resilient, being stronger. So, the main effect that the long dress has for Amira is basically higher health. While Amira is in this state, she gets an extra health bar and extra energy. Plus some, I'll get into the energy system later on in some future video. But for now, Amira has an energy system. So for the long dress, she has more energy and more health. On the opposite end, if we're being a little bit honest, such long dress would most likely be more restrictive in movement. Example, flipping, dodging, rolling, running quickly would become far more difficult. Even running actually becomes a little bit harder in this sort of dress. So what I did was reduce the movement speed, make Amira walk by default and run slowly when pressing shift. And I replaced the rolling with a simple dash ability that is used for both avoidance and charging towards enemies, because while she's dashing, she receives no damage. Now, if we go on the opposite end and go to the shorter dress and try to tie it back with the stats system, I give Amira extra movement speed by default and she gets an upgrade that increases her movement. But that's something in the upgrades tree that I will probably mention later in some future video. And she runs, and in the short dress, she runs by default and sprints when pressing shift. Now that comes with a price. The price is the lower health and the lower energy. Naturally, of course, the dress would allow for better movement range, so she can roll in this dress basically. Now, why the health and stamina was a price to be paid? Well, simply due to things like protection and safety not being the most prevalent keywords that at least that I have come across in my research, basically, for women who chose not to wear the typical traditional longer dresses. So yeah, this generally was the idea that I would implement these concepts about clothing into the game, not only as a part of the story, but also as part of the game. I did in fact then extend this thought process quite a bit into the, that it seeped into the progress, I mean the upgrades tree, abilities and weapons of Amira 2. But that will probably be the topic of the next video or the video after it. So make sure you hit the subscribe button so you do not miss the future videos. Also, one small thing I would like to mention, Amira's Steam page is actually up and running. So if you like what you see, do not hesitate to follow the link. It's also in the description. So please add it to your wish list. It really helps a lot. And lastly, as I mentioned previously, do take everything I have said with a grain of salt. I am definitely not a scientist in the topic of community and cultures, and it's only based on my personal research. So with that in mind, I'd like to say the game is still in development, so if you see any massive errors in what I have said, things that I got wrong, things that I could do better, or any ideas that come to your mind, do not hesitate to leave them on the comments. So yeah, that is all for today. I'll keep working hard on Amira, but for now, bye and salam. Hope you all have a nice day.